National Anthem Performance. It's that time of the year. Happy holidays, everyone, from 2K Sports as we get set to bring you some mid-season NBA action. Kevin Harlan here with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and we'll have David Aldridge filling us in from the sideline. Got a chance now to take a look at some numbers for Julius Randle.
And he's got it going at the foul line these days. His free throw percentage looks a lot different in the last 10 games than it did earlier in the season. He's tinkered with a few things and really improved his form.
Here are the starters for Milwaukee. Beasley on the wing along with Middleton. Lopez is the pivot with Giannis to his side. And it's Lillard in at the point. And for the Knicks, front court spots filled by Barrett and Randall. Dante DiVincenzo, he's out there with Jalen Brunson. And it's Hartenstein in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. Well, here we are, Clark. This is game two of a back-to-back for these guys, so should we expect lower energy out there?
I certainly am not counting on that. I mean, these guys are in tremendous physical condition. They can handle a quick turnaround. That's part of what they get paid to do.
So the Bucks win the tip. Brunson against Lillard. From deep, three-point land. It's rebounded by New York. They lost the last time they faced the Bucks. That one in Milwaukee.
Yeah, I mean, on the road, their defense was just overrun. Couldn't match the intensity of the opponent, and it cost them.
And you know what, guys? It just seemed like they never really had the kind of energy necessary. They just weren't comfortable on the defensive end.
Hartenstein can't get it to go. And it's the Bucks ball. When you look at this Knicks roster, Greg, this is a team that feels it can make a deep playoff push.
And they have their stars. They have tons of young talent. Developing that talent and adding a piece or two should get them where they want to go.
Now, here's DiVincenzo. After the miss from Damian Lillard, Randle is doubled from past the arc. Hartenstein can't get it to go.
Boy, I'm absolutely shocked he didn't get that one to go. Usually, he's money from deep.
The pass to Giannis. That one's in, his first shot this game.
Set him up well there. Brook Lopez showing his vision and willingness as a passer.
And here is DiVincenzo. Playing Brooklyn, he was nearly unstoppable. Just around a minute and a half into the first quarter. Brunson with a clean look, gets the three-pointer to fall.
And he likes to get in a rhythm early. Nice triple.
Lillard against Brunson. Beasley outside. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. DiVincenzo against Middleton. Randle outside. And here's DiVincenzo from the arc. That one's no good. 0 of 1 to begin the game. Middleton outside. Pass to Lopez. Kicks it out to Lillard. And it's off from three-point range.
You know, right now they're just 1 for 5. Rough start so far.
Pass to Barrett. The floater, and the rebound goes to Lopez.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And there's the call. New York with the foul. And Greg, with the coaching changes in Milwaukee, where are they looking for improvement?
Well, Kevin, they've been dominant in the regular season, but the playoffs require adjustments. That chess match is where they hope to improve.
First free throw is good. Looking at the Bucks, GA, they've made the playoffs every year since 2017.
And Kevin, as long as Giannis is at the helm, that streak should continue for a while. He's arguably the best player in the world. Guys want to play with this kid.
Milwaukee making a switch here. Bochamp's checked in.
Making it look effortless. Send this guy to the stripe. He's going to cash in more than not.
Randle kicks to Brunson. About 3 minutes gone here in the first quarter. Here's Hartenstein, and he takes the feed in stride and slams it home.
And you see how Brunson's fine-tuned his playmaking ability. That pass on time and on point.
Now Lillard. And he's currently averaging more than 26 points a game. Such a force. Count it.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now here's Brunson. Rebounded by the Bucks. They come into this one having outplayed the Magic last game.
Well, it's easy to score when you're facing very little resistance. That's why their offense looked so good in that one.
Well, I think it was a combination of things, quite honestly, but the defense didn't really offer them a challenge all night. I agree with that.
1:11 left here in the first quarter. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Here's Brunson, and he uses the glass on the layup. Brunson's got 5.
And that's terrific balance from Brunson. He does not skip leg day.
Here's Middleton. A 14-point game for him in the win against Orlando. Down low, here's Lillard. An easy 2 points on the layup.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Now here's Brunson. He's coming off a 16-point game against Brooklyn. Randle surveying the D. Over Giannis. The rebound by the Bucks. Giannis has got 4 rebounds now tonight. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. And Lillard kicks to Giannis. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. He's got 7.
You can't give Giannis a good look from 3. He's really improved that part of his game.
Brunson with it. He has 5. One second left. Green for 2 points.
And he has become deadly from that in-between area. Brunson as efficient on the midi as anybody.
And so the first quarter is in the books. The Bucks on top. They lead by 4. The second quarter coming up right after this break, so don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. And hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far, halfway through the first half in this one. Let's quickly check out the scoring breakdown here for Milwaukee.
Straight away, they've opened things up offensively with skillful passing, running smart plays, and just setting guys up for success.
Something else they're doing well tonight, guys, lots of points in the paint. Something to continue to keep our eye on.
Knicks trail by four. Jalen Brunson out there with Emmanuel Quickly. Then it's Josh Hart. And it's Taj Gibson. And it's Grimes in its small forward. There the group in New York will start the second one.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
Here's Beauchamp, Quickly covering. Here's Middleton. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
I know how unflappable Middleton is, receiving the contact on the way up and not bothered at all.
Here's Brunson. And the basket for the fourth time from the field. He's a healthy 4 for 6. And rebuilding teams, Clark, are going to ride their young prospects. But talk about the importance of having those sage veterans on that roster and their guidance.
Kevin, I don't think you can overstate it. It's critical. It's imperative. I mean, imparting that understanding of what it takes to be a professional and doing it with words and example is so valuable and so part of what veterans offer to young players and to good teams.
Knicks trail by 6. And let's head over to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. New York City remains a basketball mecca. NYC legend and former Knick Mark Jackson always talks up the basketball environment. He says, coming up in New York, it's all about the grit, the grind, the edge, the competitiveness, the swag, the confidence, the struggle, and the embracing of the bright lights. Kevin?
Well, it's all there, and it is the biggest stage for sure. David, thanks. Here's Middleton, following the score by Taj Gibson. Passes it to Beauchamp. From outside, off the mark. And so it's Brunson with it. He brings it up for New York. 4-point game. They're coming off that win against the Nets.
And really showed their depth when they needed it most. On the road, having to manufacture points.
And, you know, the guys on the bench have great confidence in themselves. And when their name was called, they were ready to compete and contribute.
Shots good by Middleton.
Nice handles by Middleton. Actually, really impressive handle. Put on a show with that dribbling exhibition.
Greg, you spent your first 4 seasons playing in New York. What's that like?
When the Knicks are winning, Kevin, there is no place you'd rather be. The fans are incredibly smart, loyal, and they'll treat you like a king. But no doubt that media pressure is for real.
And the Knicks decide to take their first time out here. And taking a broader look here at the year-over-year scoring trend for Jalen Brunson.
And one thing that has been very consistent for him the last few years, his ability to continue to deliver more and more offense. He's been doing everything that's been asked of him.
So it's the Knicks now, trailing here by 8. Lillard against Quickly. And the wide-open shot from DiVincenzo buries the long-range jumper. DiVincenzo's got himself on the board with 3 there.
And you know, Greg, they call him IQ. Instant offense is Emmanuel Quickly. Yeah, and he puts points on the board quickly. No pun intended. A volume three-point shooter and has a deadly little floater in the lane.
5 on the clock. Three-pointer, Lillard drills the three-pointer. Lillard's got the lead, back up to 8 now for the Bucks.
The real. Come at us, and we're coming right back at you.
A little back and forth from long range. I love it. That's a terrific answer there.
Now, here's Barrett. A 14-point game for him in the win against the Nets in Brooklyn. Giannis outside. Outside Portis. Off target there. That would have pushed the lead to double digits. For New York, they've gone 3-7 shooting the ball here in the second quarter. And it's Quickly missing.
You look at him, and he's a little hit and miss from there, even without a defender in his face. No guarantee.
Giannis, a screen on Barrett. Three-pointer, Lillard. There's his 3rd field goal, and now he's made half of his 6 shots.
He's starting to find himself out there now. You know, he's taking much better shots here in the second quarter.
Here's Randle on the wing, DiVincenzo. Here's Beasley, still without a basket. Lillard misses. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. And there's the pass to DiVincenzo. Randle outside. On the wing, Quickly. And the 3 off target. Milwaukee leading by 11. Connaughton finds Giannis. Spins. Beasley outside. And he beats the buzzer. Wow!
Yeah, that's just an amazing play to get that ball off in time.
I agree. I mean, and to have the composure to lock in and get off a shot he feels confident about, that's good work.
And so it's Milwaukee with a 14-point lead as we bring the quarter to a close. They've been playing some ferocious defense. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks very much. Tips, going against a high-powered offense like this, I know you have your work cut out for you at the defensive end.
Yeah, you know, they're tough to guard. They put a lot of pressure on you. You can't make body position mistakes. You got to make sure we try to make them work for the points.
We'll see if you can be more effective in the second half. Thanks. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. And we'll be back after halftime as the 3rd quarter gets underway.
Good to see you, and welcome. A lopsided game through 2 quarters and a big deficit for the New York Knicks. All right, fellas, back in your playing days, what was your favorite city to eat in?
Whatever city Kitty was in, I'd go steal his lunch, then we beat his team on the court same night.
Wait, just for the record, that never happened.
Now taking a look at that first half of action, it's been tough sledding for the Knicks.
They need to focus on getting high percentage looks. Right now, they're taking the first shot. Not the best shot. Guys need to move their feet, set screens, open up these shooters.
Might be something under discussion as we speak. Thanks for spending halftime with us. Time to get it back out to Kevin Harlan for the start of the 3rd quarter.
And there wasn't too much drama in the first half, but maybe things will tighten up here in the second. One guy who's been getting it done is Jalen Brunson.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half, absolute dynamite on offense.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
Here's who Adrian Griffin is starting the second half with. We'll see the talented pair of Middleton and Giannis at forward. Damian Lillard out there with Malik Beasley. And it's Lopez in at center. And with an update from the sidelines, let's check in with David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. Giannis Antetokounmpo remains so consistent. He said, I want to get to the position that my game is boring. People don't talk about it because I do it every single night, but I don't get bored. The greats, the best players, never get bored. They always give their best every given night, and that's my mindset. Kevin?
Oh, DA, I love it. Thank you so much for the report. Brunson, good.
Well, you certainly can't fault him as the reason they're behind. He's been on target and on top of his game.
Second half just getting started, about a minute played. And we know they like having Brunson out there, Greg, a player they can run the entire offense through.
No doubt. And he can be trusted on to take the keys and just run things effectively. He keeps mistakes to a minimum, and he's a solid creator for his teammates.
And here's Brunson following the three-pointer by Chris Middleton. And Brunson, here we go. It's hauled in by Giannis. Antetokounmpo's got his sixth rebound on the night.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Now here's Brunson after the miss from Damian Lillard. Brunson kicks to Barrett. Some nice passing by New York here. From deep. And again, New York with the triple.
There's the unselfishness you like to see in a guard. DiVincenzo keeping his eyes up and his options open.
Here's Lillard. He's got eight. Outside, out of the Kumbo. Goes back up. Lopez. And he converts the layup. Lopez has got 4 points in the quarter.
Just a grinder. Always doing the dirty work on the offensive glass. And that's one of the things he brings to the table.
And with that, the Bucks lead has got down to 11 points with that bucket from Brunson.
And defensively, if you are not on point, Brunson more than capable of finishing inside.
Well, we're into the third quarter. Just over 2.5 minutes played. And here's Giannis. He has 7. Pulls it up. Buries the jump shot. Giannis has got 9.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
Yeah, that's not the defense you need. You got to be tougher defensively.
Here's Hartenstein. Currently averaging almost 6 points a game. Floats one. Lopez with the steal. And Beasley, here we go. 7-foot shot. And no good. Trying to use the glass. Knicks trail by 13. Randall down low. Covered by Giannis. Back to Randall. Pass to Barrett. And here's Brunson. Lets it go from deep. And the Knicks hit again from deep.
Their three-point percentage has taken a big leap here in this second half.
And their lasers are starting to do their thing. I mean, that's going to be the ticket for them the rest of the way.
Antetokounmpo against Randall. Antetokounmpo gets to Middleton. And a great assist by Antetokounmpo as that one goes in. Middleton's got 6 points in the quarter. New York calls timeout.
the Bucks making a change here.
And a moment here to see the numbers for Randle, putting up about 22 points per, 9 rebounds, and 5 assists. And you talk about guys who just have a nose for putting up points. He is one of them.
Yeah, he sure is, and he rarely has back-to-back bad games. If he has an off night, he usually follows that up with a big night.
We've got 108 left to play in the third. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot 2 at the free throw line.
Just an attacker is Randle. Always seems like he's being sent to the line.
And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for Milwaukee.
Well, I think they've been lethal from beyond the arc this game, no doubt about it. Hard to defend such spot-on shooting.
And another stat that they've excelled at is points off assists. They're moving the ball around and creating great looks for one another.
The first one falls.
And, you know, the impressive ascension of Randle has been a lot of fun to watch. I mean, he's a double-double threat who plays with relentless energy.
Both shots good from the stripe. Now Giannis. 9 points in the game so far. And the double up Antetokounmpo. That's good from Payne on the assist by Antetokounmpo.
It's obvious they've taken fewer threes here in the second half and are focused on having a more balanced offensive attack.
41 seconds left in the third. Now, here's Quickly. Payne covering. Here's Grimes. And the Knicks miss again. Milwaukee leading by 13. Giannis right side. To Beauchamp, takes a 3, and another 3 for Milwaukee.
The edge on the glass is the difference. It's allowed them to build this lead.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
And an eye for an eye. Both teams working to stretch the floor.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets 3, you fire 3 of your own. Boom.
And so it's Milwaukee. Looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. They've had such great ball movement and shot selection, and it's led to a terrific field goal percentage. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here. And a quick look now at the State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Yeah, and with the accuracy to go along with that vision. I mean, he put the ball in the absolute perfect spot. That's how you orchestrate it.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. Taj Gibson is out there with Josh Hart. Then it's Jalen Brunson. Then there's Emmanuel Quickly. And it's Grimes in at the 3, the small forward. That's the 5 for New York right now.
And it's the moment Lillard passes half court, you have to pick him up because Dame's range is endless.
Here's Quickly. It's good. Quickly's got his first points of the night.
And now they're shooting it pretty well. That was not something we would have said in that first half.
Beasley against Quickly. Portis, the pass to Lillard. Shoots over Brunson. Rebounded by Hart.
Well, you know, they're in the lead, but he's still been frustrated from an offensive standpoint.
passes it to Grimes. Six to shoot. Here's Quickley. And the Knicks hit again from deep.
Boy, Harden is one of those guys you look at and you can just see the team is first with him. Never hesitates to find the open guy.
Here's Beasley. The pass to Portis. To the middle. Lillard from outside. And again, Milwaukee with the triple.
And with that three, his second of the half, he's equaled his total from before the break.
About a minute and a half through the fourth quarter now. Brunson scanning the floor. And there are the Knicks with another bucket.
And man, can Brunson get going in a hurry? He's got his fingerprints all over this one.
Timeout called, the Bucks. A different look for Milwaukee. Brook Lopez has checked in for Lopez. Antetokounmpo comes in for Portis. And Middleton subbed in for Pat Connaughton. And now the latest from our reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys. Here was Adrian Griffith's message during the huddle. He reminded his team, we're up. All the pressure is on them. Let's just keep playing our game. Makes sense because they've got a nice lead late in this game. Back to you guys.
Thank you, David. And Beasley has the ball here for the Milwaukee Bucks. At one point, they led by 16. Last quarter of play, about 2 minutes in now. Lillard misses.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
You know what? That's a confidence shaker for him, though. I mean, that's a shot he expects to make every time.
Brunson, and it's sent back by Lopez.
Big Brook Lopez gobbling up space and getting the block on that play.
On the wing, DiVincenzo. Covered by Beasley. Just five to shoot. Randle from outside.
Yeah, I don't want to dismiss the defensive chops of Antetokounmpo. I mean, he is so good at handling himself on the defensive end, whether he's guarding his own guy or in position to help his teammates.
Here's the three. Milwaukee, no good that time either. Knicks trail by 12. Randle finds Brunson. To the paint. Here's Hartenstein. Lopez with the block. Now here's Giannis. Lopez, a screen on Brunson. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. Hands on Jalen Brunson.
And when you talk about Giannis's defense, he really has some unique attributes.
Boy, does he ever, Greg. I mean, you think about his length, his athleticism, his agility. He's a guy who can defend the ball and the screener almost at the same time because of that great length. So offenses sometimes go away from him in the pick and roll, which allows him to kind of play free safety on that back line as a rim protector.
Two shots.
First free throw is good.
You really have to appreciate and respect the spirit Giannis plays the game with, a beacon of energy and enthusiasm for his team. They all feed off of him with an attitude of joy and unselfishness.
Good on both. And with the new CBA, Clark, one thing that again didn't get any traction, the franchise tag.
Yeah, not surprising. I mean, if a guy really wants to leave a team these days, most of the time a trade will be made. It doesn't necessarily have to get to free agency.
1:36 left to play here in the fourth. It falls for his fifth field goal tonight, now shooting 5 for 8.
And guys, what we saw here tonight is one side having everything going for them. Huge margin of victory for the Bucks.
You know, it's tough to put your finger on the deciding factor in this one, but I'd say that the shooting accuracy made the difference.
Yeah, I think you're on point, Kevin. They got better looks, and that tends to lead to a better field goal percentage.
And so looking at their number, this will be win number 22 on the year. And, you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
Boy, I like how he mixed it up on the glass. Wasn't afraid to get in there and do the dirty work. Showed some real grit and toughness tonight.
Time call here. The Knicks decide to talk it over. They trail by 13. There's 1:17 left in the fourth quarter. Knicks trail by 13. Randall a screen on Lillard. From deep, Brunson. And again, New York with the triple.
And this is the game plan for him. He's a big part of their floor spacing.
And you know what? It's all about the long distance game for him tonight. He's getting it done from out there.
And Lillard gets to Middleton. There's the triple. And Damian Lillard with the bucket on the assist by Middleton.
And it's just competing, you know, giving your best when it matters most.
Yeah, you know, once they got victory in their view, a huge injection of energy and a great run to finish it off.
Here's Brunson. And no good that time. Nice D from Lillard. And here's Lillard. He brings it up for Milwaukee.
At one point, they led by 16. From downtown, Randle grabs the board. Shot and game clock separated by 5. Pass to Brunson. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a 3-point play.
Oh, gritty make by Brunson. That guy plays way bigger than his size.
Here's Beauchamp. So no problem for Milwaukee as they get the win. And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thanks very much, Giannis. Huge, big win tonight. How did you do it?
I think we just had fun. I think our guys were running to their spots, and we were able to drive the lanes and made the right pass, and we were knocked down shots, the ball was moving, we were defending, we were having fun, so that's why we got to win.
So you need to patent that formula, I guess. Congrats on the win, man. Thanks. Back to you.
All right, David, thanks so much. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan along with our terrific 2K Sports crew, thanking you for tuning in. As we present our New Balance Player of the Game, Damian Lillard.